If you're successful and you want to show it, you might consider investing in Huawei's latest flagship, the Mate 8. Touted as a new style of business by Huawei, but does the Mate 8 actually live up to its reputation? At least on paper it does, but since we don't do papers, this is our review of the Huawei Mate 8. Let's get the obvious out of the way. The Huawei Mate 8 is a gorgeous looking device, starring a polished unibody metallic design with chamfered edges. Whilst other manufacturers have moved on to the Quad HD bandwagon, Huawei decided on a 6-inch 1080p IPS display, good for 338 ppi. The viewing angles are pretty good, and though you won't get the vivid colors of AMOLEDs, color reproduction on the Mate 8 display is more realistic. As is the norm these days, the Huawei Mate 8 comes equipped with a fingerprint scanner. I'll go on a limb and say this is the fastest I have used so far, and it still works regardless of fingerprint orientation or position. For a big phone, the Mate 8 manages to sit comfortably in the hand, and people with big hands like myself can even operate the device with one hand. You should also consider using a case or cover, as the phone can get quite slippery because of the polished metal design. Luckily, Huawei also includes a cover when you purchase this device. In terms of power, this is as good as it gets. The Mate 8 puts to shame flagships like the Samsung Galaxy S6 or the iPhone 6. The Mate 8 got a 1648 single core and 5775 multi-core score on Geekbench. The Kirin 950 chipset and the Mali T880 GPU, as well as 3 GB of RAM, keep the phone quite snappy, even when running power-intensive games and apps. Personally, I'm a huge fan of stock Android, but the Mate 8 comes with Huawei's 4th iteration of its Emotion UI. The lack of an app drawer and the startling resemblance to iOS puts a stain on what would have been a perfect phone. The Mate 8 is a dual SIM device, which can run 4G on both cards, or you could just use the slot for an SD card. The Mate 8 works across different carriers and networks globally. Chances are, it already supports your region. Camera performance is exceptional. The phone features a 16 megapixel sensor, which can take modest looking images in well-lit conditions. However, low light performance is not great. Even when using HDR, the Mate 8 can capture 1080p footage up to 60 frames per second, and 720p footage up to 120 frames per second. It also can do slow motion. To power all this, Huawei used the 4000 mAh non-replaceable battery, which can guarantee users a full day of moderate usage. And there are also other power saving options included when need be. The Mate 8 is running on Android 6.0 Marshmallow. But be warned, if you're going to buy the Huawei Mate 8, you need very deep pockets, pun intended. The phone is retailing around $650 and is available in selected stores across Zimbabwe. In conclusion, the Huawei Mate 8 is a very good smartphone if you can afford it. This is Marston for netcreed.com. As usual, if you like the video, please press the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video.